उम्र भी बहुत छोटी हो जाएगी। इस प्रकार से कलयुग भयंकर आ रहा है, सोचने लगे हमें क्या करना चाहिए। रामचंद्र
हरे कृष्ण। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल श्री गुरुदेव showed his gratitude towards the organizer of this temple, President Arora Sahib and Varma Sahib and others, and Pujari, etc., that they allowed to speak on the Indian Vedic culture. And then Srila Gurudev is so much delighted to see in this place of Canada, Vancouver, so many devotees, not only from Vancouver, but from other places of US also, have gathered here together. So Srila Gurudev is explaining that once upon a time, when Kaliyuga just started, so many sages, 88,000 sages, they gathered together at the bank of river Gomti, Nainisharan, and they were very much worried that Kaliyuga has come. In this Kaliyuga, all the women and men, they will give up their dharma, religion, their duties, even sannyasi. They will be living more opulently than grihastha. Their living places will not be places, will be palaces. And they will all those facilities, even those ordinary grihastha doesn't have. They also, in this Kali Yuga, people will be very much unfortunate. They will try to endeavor to have happiness, but it will result into miseries. IU, age will be also very small, and they will be very unhappy. This is the period of Kali Yuga. What should they do?
ऋषि आस्ट सुत गोस्वामी दैट ओ सुत यू आर वेरी हाई क्लास ऑफ डिसाइपल ऑफ श्री सुखदेव गोस्वामी यू हैव हर्ड फ्रॉम हिम essence of all Ved, Upanishad, Gita, Srimad Bhagavat. And from Parashar Rishi, you have heard all Vedic literature like Ved, Upanishad. So you know everything. We want that now Kaliyuga coming very short. The life will be very short. And they will be, in the persons, in the Kaliyuga, they will be unloving. So you should tell us that how soul will be had. He did not ask how we will be happy. Because they used to know that this body is not myself. I am not this body. We are soul. Eternal servant of Supreme Lord Krishna. So they asked, how soul will be happy. Hearing this, Sut Goswami became very happy. And he remembered all the sweet pastimes of Krishna and his instructions. And then he did pranam to his Gurudev and told after that, Savai Punsang परो धर्मो जतो भक्ति रथो खजे अहेतु का अप्रध्याता जयात्मा संप्रसिद्ध। He became very happy and then remembered all the sweet pastimes of Krishna. And then he began to tell, oh, Sanat Rishi, you should hear. The Param Dharma, transcendental religion of all the beings, not only human, to serve the Supreme Lord. Continuously, Taidharavat Avichinna Gati Se Nirantarjamai Bhakti, and without any reason, naturally, then it is Paramdharma, and by doing so, any soul can be happy. Otherwise, never he can be happy. Also, one disciple of Srila Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Srila Rupa Goswami, had written a parallel slope, but some all inclusive. ऐसा श्लोक जिसमें पहले पहले के जितने भी भक्ति की परिभाषाएं थी सब उसके अंतर्गत थी। ऐसा सुंदर श्लोक भक्ति के लिए सुनाया। What was that? Annyabhilashita sunyam Gyan karmadhyana vritam Anukulena krishna musilanam bhakti ruttama. Try to hear very patiently and carefully. Because we are doing all bhakti. But what is bhakti really? We don't realize. टेलिंग वह कह रहे हैं कि अनुकुलेन कृष्णानुशीलनम भक्ति, अपने तन से आप लिख लीजिएगा, बोल दीजिएगा, कोई अपने तन से, मन से, वचन से और भावना से कृष्ण को प्रसन्न होने वाली, कृष्ण के लिए सुखदायी जो चेष्टाएं हैं वो तैल धारावत अविच्छिन्न गति से कृष्ण में लगी रहे और भक्तों के, गुरु के अनुगत्य में हो, ये भक्ति हो। भक्ति तो हुई किंतु यदि उसमें अन्नाभिलाषिता शून्य, कृष्ण की सेवा के अतिरिक्त और किसी दूसरे उद्देश्य से हो, अपने लिए बने भक्ति, तो वो भक्ति नहीं शुद्ध है, वो सकाम भक्ति है। ठाकुर जी के मंदिर में आए, लक्ष्मी नारायण जी के यहां, और हाथ जड़े जोड़ करके बोले जी, प्रभु हमारा लड़का बहुत बीमार है, वो ठीक हो जाए तो आपको हम साल चढ़ाएंगे या मिठाइयां चढ़ाएंगे, तो ये भक्ति नहीं, ये अपने लिए हो गई, सकाम हो गई, भक्ति से नीचे हो गई। इसलिए कृष्ण की सेवा के अतिरिक्त किसी प्रकार के भी अपने लिए कोई भी चेष्टा न हो, इसको भक्ति कहते हैं। और वो ज्ञान और कर्म के अधीन न रहे, उससे ढकी हुई न रहे। तात्पर्य क्या, हम कर्म करने के लिए बाध्य हैं, चलते हैं, फिरते हैं, देखते हैं, सुनते हैं, खाते हैं, ये भी कर्म है, इसके बिना तो हम रह नहीं सकते। तो कर्म ऐसा हो जो भक्ति से संबंधित हो, भगवान से संबंधित हो। बाजार जा रहे हैं सब्जी लाने के लिए, फल लाने के लिए, किसी लिए, अपने लिए, तो ये कर्म हो गया। मैं जा रहा हूं बाजार से, ये भगवान की सेवा के लिए फल मूल कंद लाने जा रहा हूं, ये भक्ति। यदि कर्म के साथ में ये भक्ति हुई कर्म से, तो उससे ढकी हुई हो जाती है, उसको कर्म मिश्रा भक्ति कहते हैं। और बिना ज्ञान के भी नहीं रह सकते। तो कैसा ज्ञान, मैं ही ब्रह्म हूं, सारा जगत ब्रह्म है, सर्वम खलु इदं ब्रह्म, हम ब्रह्मास्मि। यदि ऐसा ज्ञान हो तो ये भक्ति का विरोधी है, ये भक्ति को ढक देता है। किंतु कृष्ण का तत्व, जीव तत्व, माया तत्व, हम क्या हैं, भगवान कौन है, भगवान का प्रेम कैसा होता है, राधा जी का तत्व क्या है, गोपियों का तत्व क्या है, ये तत्व भक्ति का सहायक है, कर्म को नहीं ढकता। इसलिए हमको ऐसा ही ज्ञान होना चाहिए। किंतु ज्ञान से ही कृष्ण भक्ति हो जाएगी, ये नहीं बात है, सहायक है। इसलिए जो भक्ति में अपना कोई सुख की बात नहीं हो और ज्ञान और कम से ही भक्ति होती है, ये विचार न रहे और अपने तन मन वचन और भावना की चेष्टाओं को कृष्ण को के लिए ही हो, तो उसे उत्तमा भक्ति कहते हैं, अर्थात उसे प्रेमा भक्ति कहते हैं। थोड़ा सबोध दीजिए जो कहा।
In our scriptures, so many definitions have been given about bhakti. But our Srila Rupa Goswami Pad, who had been pioneer disciple of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has given a definition of bhakti. It's so exclusive definition that it includes all the previous definition of scriptures in itself, and also give very precisely and perfectly that what is Uttama Bhakti. It says that we should try to understand what is Bhakti. Anya Abhilashita Shunyam Gyan Karam Adi Anavritam Anupulen Krishna Anushilanam Bhaktir Uttama. Krishna Anushilanam Anupulen. That by our tan, man, vachan, body, mind, and speech, and by our all feelings, we should endeavor, we should make efforts to please Krishna. Our all the efforts should be for the pleasure of Krishna. And these efforts must be perpetual, continuous, without any break, and in accordance with and in following of our spiritual master. This is called bhakti. But we have to understand that what is uttama bhakti, what is high class of bhakti. this bhakti should be anabhilashita shunyam. There should not be any other desire than to please Krishna. If we come to temple, to Lakshmi Narayan temple, and then we pay our obeisances, but we say, "Oh Thakurji, my son is very sick. Please, he should be cured. I will give one shawl to you, or I will offer so many sweets." Is it pure bhakti? No. This is sakam bhakti. Therefore, our endeavor should be free from any other desire. Also, it should not be covered by our karma. Srila Gurudev is explaining, we all are forced to do some karma. Karma means action. We are all forced to do some karma. We are going to market. We are going to purchase vegetables and fruits. If we are going to purchase all these things for ourselves, then it is karma. This will bind us. If we are going to purchase vegetables and fruits for Krishna, then this karma is bhakti. Therefore, all the karma should be for Krishna, so that it should not cover our bhakti. Also, important thing is that it should not be covered by jnana. We live in this world. Jnana means knowledge. It's very important. We cannot neglect knowledge. But if we think that we are ourselves Brahm, that no one is other than superior to this Brahm, this type of knowledge, this covers bhakti. This reduces our bhakti. We should not cultivate such type of knowledge. We should try to cultivate to know what is Jivatma, living entity, what is Paramatma, what is Bhagavan, what is God, what is the God's abode, who is Radharani, what is true love. All these things, all this knowledge, it is favorable to bhakti. But remember one thing, still it is not bhakti. And therefore our all cultivation of knowledge should be in this regard, so that it should not cover our bhakti. Hence we should now understand that what is for Uttama Bhakti. In fact, Uttama Bhakti is Prema Bhakti. It should be free from other desires other than pleasing Krishna. Our all endeavors and efforts in order to please Krishna without being covered by jnana and karma, that will result into Uttama Bhakti.
Kintu Adhoksar Indriyatit Bhagavan hai kaun? Who is that Supreme Lord Bhagavan? In Bhagavad it has been told. Ete chans kala unsa krishnastu bhagavan. So Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead. Krishna has come in the form of Ram also. He has come also in the form of Nrisimhadev. His prakash vaibhav is Lakshmi Narayan. But see, Shankarji Mahadev, he is Bhakta, not Bhagavan. He is like a Vaishnava Guru. So we should respect him like Bhakta, not like Bhagavan. Why Krishna is supposed to be Supreme Lord, Supreme Personality of Godhead? Because we see, if anyone go to see Lakshmi Narayan and he asks him, be your very dear wife, he will reject. Oh, Lakshmi is there. No other. If anyone will go and ask him, oh, we all want to dance and sing in Rash with you. He can do Rash. Even Sri Ramchandra, anyone will tell that we want to serve you as your wife. Oh, he tell, I'm very chaste. Oh, Sita is my wife. How I can? And if anyone tell that we want to dance and sing in Rash with you, oh, I cannot do. You know that when Ramchandra was in forest, Dandakaranya, there were 60,000 of rishis and munis. When they saw Ram, they were doing austerities to be gopis and to be in Rash with Krishna. Ramchandra then told, give benediction. I cannot do Rash. Please, I will make you in Krishna Lila Gopi when early be Krishna. And there you can dance and sing. So, anyone cannot do Rash except Sri Krishna. He is personality of Aishwarya and Madhurya both. That is not somehow
possible
in Ram, in Lakshmi Narayan and other incarnation of Krishna. So, Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead. Then, I was telling the definition of bhakti.
ये कुछ हिंदी में भी बता दो यहाँ के
हिंदी का है
नहीं ये कृष्ण वाली बात ना यहाँ के हिंदी सुनने वाले भी हैं उनको भी बता दो
मैं जो आपने अंग्रेजी में बताया तो हिंदी में बता दिए तो अच्छा रहेगा
यहाँ के लोग
हिंदी में भी बतला
पढ़ते हैं जो ये वाली खास कर बात
भगवान कौन है राम से बात करने पर ये नहीं होगा नारायण से बात नहीं होगा नहीं कर सकते
कृष्ण स्वयं भगवान है वे ऐश्वर्य और माधुर्य की मूर्ति है नारायण ने केवल ऐश्वर्य है माधुर्य नहीं उनके कोई जन्म लीला नहीं कोई